My name is Sufyan and you are watching Retail Zone. In this video, we are going to discuss about a very good strategy, and this strategy works on a 5-minute candle and with a 5-minute expiry time. Although I do not recommend doing martingales, but in this strategy you can also do martingale trades at some point, okay? So now let's begin with the strategy settings. First of all guys, you need to set a support line at round numbers, okay? If you zoom out over here, okay, you can see round numbers, and in the round number you can see 00 in the end, okay, like 1.52500. This may be 600, 700, 800. So in the end of every number you see two zeros, okay, two times zero. But when you zoom in, you find some more round numbers, so you don't need to place your lines on that round number. We just need to place our lines on these double zeros, okay? For that you need to zoom out, and now you can see this round numbers. Just simply draw horizontal lines on this round number, okay? And try to draw perfectly on the round number. Okay guys, so now you have done this, then now you just need to wait for a candle to close at a round number. And guys, remember, even this candle closed at a round number, okay, with a rejection, okay, but on this candle if you would have placed a put option, then you might have lost this trade. So we can use a martingale trade in order to cover our losses and make some profit with this trade, okay? And if you see this candle, it closed with a big rejection, okay? This candle, this hammer type bearish candle, it closed with a big rejection at the round number, okay? Even though this was a losing trade, but if you martingale with this trade, with this candle, okay, you will recover your losses as well as make profit. So now if you see this candle is being rejected from the sellers, and it might close below this line or near to this line, so we can place a put option for 5 minutes expiry, okay guys? So let this candle to close. Now I will place a trade for 5 minutes expiry. Okay, I placed my trade, okay? And remember guys, do not ever place big trades, okay? Always place small trades, maximum 3 to 5% of your total balance, okay? So I have placed a $3 trade. Now we will just wait for this trade to close. We will not do multiple entries, okay? We will not do any re-entries. We will just wait for this candle to close. Suppose this candle makes you lose this trade, then we will again place a down trade for 5 minutes expiry on the next candle, but this time we will just double our amount, okay? But we expect this to be a winning trade, because as you saw, this candle got a big rejection and it closed near the round number, okay? So now we will just wait for this candle to close. This candle will close above this line, then we will again place a trade for 5 minutes expiry, and we will double the amount this time. And this is the correct way to use martingale, guys. Okay, now as you can see guys, we got just 10 seconds left and we are about to win this trade. And if it doesn't win, then let me double my amount, and on the next candle again I will place a trade. But we won this trade guys, okay? So guys, this is very simple strategy guys. You don't need to draw much of support and resistance level. Just focus on one thing, that you have to control your emotions, okay? Do not get involved badly in emotions. Like if you lose one trade, then do not place a higher amount trade. Follow the martingale strategy properly, okay? And guys, one more thing what I forgot to tell is that if you see a round number And if you see a previous rejection like this, okay, we placed our trade over here, okay, and the market went down. And if we see the past, in the past the market got rejected from the same round number on the same point, okay, then definitely the winning ratio will be more. And guys, if you see over here, this time the market broke this round number level and the candle closed down and with a small rejection, but it is very far away from the round number line, so we will avoid placing trades. And if you see that the candle closes above this line and on the next candle, if you lose a trade with a big rejection, then you can use Martin call. Okay, here the candle closed far away from this line, so at this point we should not place a call option, because if you see here, there is a difference. This candle closed above this line, okay, so on the second candle we can win with the martingale strategy. But here if you see the candle closed far down from this line, so we should avoid placing trades in this area, okay. And other thing what I needed to tell you is, if you see over here, the market went up here and then it came down, okay, and for the first time market reached here, okay, this was the first time, okay, here you can place a call option, okay. Again market came down, okay, you might place a trade on this candle, you might lose, on this candle you might win, okay. This was the first time, this was the second time. For the third time, if you see the market again going up and coming down and closing on the line, this round number line, then on the next candle again you can place a trade for the third time. But guys, for the fourth time you will not place your trade, okay, you will only place your trade three times, because normally market only respects a certain level max three times, okay, one to three times. So for the three times you can place your trades, but avoid placing your trade on the fourth time, okay. As you can see, even the fourth time this level has been respected and the candle went up, but for the fifth time even the candle closed with the rejection, but the market came straight away down. So just place your trade three times, okay, maximum three times. Do not place on the fourth or fifth time, okay guys. Do not just use one chart to trade, okay. Draw lines on all the charts. Like if you see over here, this is a very strong round number because it ends with three zeros. It got a big rejection. If I just zoom out over here and I draw horizontal lines, okay, we just need to draw lines near our candles, okay. So our candle traveled from here to here, so we draw these three lines, okay. You can also draw here line, but there's no need because the candle did not reach there, so we will just draw three lines, okay, near the round numbers which ends with at least two zeros. If it's the three zeros, then it's the most powerful round number, okay guys. So now I have drawn this. Now suppose if you would have taken a trade on this candle, okay, because it closes near the round number, this trade you might have lost. But again, if you would have placed a trade with doubling your amount on this candle, you would have got a deep ITM and you would have recovered your losses and make some profit with this candle. And guys, the most important thing, sorry I forgot to tell you, do not ever trade in a bad market, okay. Always place your trades in a good market, okay. This is a kind of good market where you see good formations of candle, okay. Whenever you see such type of market where the candle are very small or most of the candle ends up with a long wicks, then avoid placing your trades in such market, guys, okay. Okay, this is kind of like okay market, and if you see this market, this is a bad market, guys. Avoid placing your trades when you see market in such situation, okay. Just stay away from the market because you don't want to lose your money. And if you see over here, this is also a kind of good market, okay. Now कि आई प्लेस्ड माई ट्रेड ओवर हियर ऑल्दो आई वॉज रिलेट टू प्लेस माई ट्रेड बट दैट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम एंड द रीजन वाई आई प्लेस्ड माई ट्रेड आई विल शो यू गाइस इफ आई zoom out and draw lines on the round numbers. Okay, so this candle closed near the round number, this bullish candle, and that's why I placed a put option for 5 minutes expiry, guys. As you can see over here, even this candle closed, this green candle closed above this line, and we saw a bearish candle. After again we saw a bullish candle closing on this line, after again we saw a fall in the market. Okay guys, so don't need to place trade on each candle, just at the round numbers. If you place a trade and if you lose, then just double your amount and again place your trade, 2 to 3 steps guys, because it's not ever possible that the market will always go up, 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 up and never come down, or it's not even possible the market will always go down and never come up. If you are trading on a strong support like this, like on round number, then definitely you will be in profit guys. Okay, so you can do martingales 2 to 3 steps at round numbers guys, remember. So that's it for the video guys. I hope you understood what I mean to explain over here. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like this video, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care.